Jerry Agar for Ezra Levant. I can tell you why so many government budgets get as out of control and bloated as they do. Too many citizens are so low in good character and so ignorant of what personal responsibility is that they make themselves feel good by spending other people's money and then viciously attacking the people who care enough to call for responsibility in the spending of scarce dollars. Now, I'm talking about the people who will support any social spending program at any amount, no matter how wasteful of the dollars that could be used to solve real problems for actual poor and disadvantaged people it may be. Because they confuse the spending of other people's money in wasteful ways with caring and doing. It's not caring to waste other people's money. It's not doing anything to just say you want other people's money spent. To do both while attacking the people who call for responsibility in these matters is intellectually lazy and socially ugly. Now, this comes to mind today because my fellow radio talk host Ryan Doyle and I had a discussion on my show about the city of Toronto voting to add over $1 million to the breakfast programs at schools. We, Ryan and I, feel that too many people taking advantage of the program do not need it. They just want it. That $1 million could be used for other programs in the city. We got a call from a man who admitted that he can afford his expenses. But his kids sleep in, and then they dash off to school, knowing they can take advantage of the taxpayers. He's a greedy, lazy man raising greedy, lazy kids. Ryan and I agreed that a program for truly disadvantaged children is a good thing. What has me steamed is what happened on the show that follows mine. Callers ignored the part about the necessity of the program's usefulness in their zeal to prove themselves to be caring people. This lady called in to tell us all what a horrible person Ryan is, and by extension, of course, how great she is for championing a bloated program for the greedy at your expense.
I want to say, though, that since Ryan Doyle became a conservative, he almost has the same traits as a born-again Christian or a smoker that became a non-smoker. You know, they're holier than thou, and nobody else's opinion matters.
Perhaps instead of deriding Christians, this woman should look into the great work churches do around the world for the disadvantaged. And by the way, they don't do it to get votes or to prop up unionized jobs. They do it out of a commitment to their faith and a real love of their fellow human beings. But she isn't about to let reason and common sense get in the way of her hateful anti-Christian bigotry. And how does she think we can help the poor if we're so willing to blindly shovel money to programs based not any longer on proven need, but merely on want, on greed and laziness? Politicians who garner votes based on this false concern for the poor from citizens who puff themselves up at the expense of others get their votes from guys like this.
Could you try and see if Jerry could do it in a program? You know, he can do it as a joke if he wants. Try and do a program about how they should just sort of lure all the poor people together and kill them and see how many people phone up to say that's a really good idea.
So let me get this straight. If I suggest that there may be a better, more cost-effective way to provide services for the needy, instead of providing something for everyone without a means test, I would support killing the poor. How arrogant and ignorant does one have to be to assume that anyone who questions the social program status quo is out to literally annihilate the poor? In Ontario, the government's rolling out an expensive all-day kindergarten babysitting program that advisors to the government have said is too expensive and unaffordable. But logic be damned, the government is hell-bent on rolling out a liberal legacy project to appease parents who will enjoy the free daycare. There may well be underprivileged kids who could benefit from this program, but the fact that its eventual goal is to provide it to every family in the province is foolhardy and all too typical of government-run feel-good projects. By trying to provide programs to everyone, you end up shortchanging the legitimately worthy recipients of such programs. We don't offer wheelchairs to everyone on the off chance they may need one. We have programs that target people who will need help, and we provide it, and that is a good thing. Now, does that sound ridiculous? Well, of course it does. But it's just as ridiculous to go to such lengths with breakfast programs and all-day early childhood education to the point that the children of the richest people in the nation are included. Why do we need to provide breakfast to every single kid? My kids don't leave the house hungry. Do yours? Should governments send welfare checks to everybody so as not to single anyone out? Well, that would be ludicrous too, but it's the same thing. By trying to be all things to all people, these programs become top-heavy and pointless. Imagine the kind of nutritious breakfast that could be provided for the truly needy if we didn't use this approach, if we only provided for those who are actually in need. Imagine how much more we could do to help get them out of that situation, rather than a Band-Aid solution that does little but prop up more programs, wasting tax dollars as we provide unnecessary services. We could help families rise out of poverty with an ultimate goal of shutting down breakfast programs altogether. Why? For lack of need. That should be the goal. And to those people who take advantage of these programs when they don't need to the people who think they are somebody special because they'll vote to spend other people's money with no care or regard to its effectiveness, and to the politicians who spend it, shame on all of you. You don't care about the poor. You care about yourselves and your shaky, unearned, unattractive self-esteem.